With that, let's jump into the next section, which is how do you really achieve operational excellence? What's the process? Well, first we design lean value streams, then we implement a lean flow, then we make that flow visual, and we create standard work for that lean flow. And you know what? A lot of companies have done number one, number two, number three, and even number four. That's been around for a while, okay? And then, here we go, gets tougher now. Make that abnormal flow visual, create standard work for abnormal flow. What's that guy talking about up there, right? This is what we use management for. Teach employees to maintain, improve the flow to customer, and then work on offense, all right? So these are the principles that get us there. The first one, design lean value streams. I have to say something here. I mean, I've done a lot of value stream training, and this keyword is the word design, all right? For example, in the book, Learning to See, Mike Rother, John Shook, has kind of spelled it out for us, but I think half the people missed the chapter 3 on designing a lean value stream, all right? Because there are actually 8 guidelines that tell us how to build a future state. I can't tell you how many companies I go and do value stream mapping and say, well, here's our current state, and here's all the Kaizens we need to do. Here's our current state. How did you do the future state? Well, we looked at this, and we Kaizened, we brainstormed, we got together in a room, and that's how we developed the future state. Yeah, that's not how it's done. Not if you want to achieve operational excellence. There's actually some guidelines in here that Mike taught us about, which was all about, you know, TACT and finished good strategy, one piece flow. We added FIFO to it, supermarkets, scheduling 1 point, setting up intervals, determining pitch, are all things that have to be inside a value stream to design our big end-to-end value stream. Beyond that, once you do the deep dive, that gives you the basic 8, give us the receiving debt to shipping debt, but then it gets a lot deeper into mixed model, how you're going to schedule that pacemaker, and there's 10 things that the mixed model pacemaker has to follow. You know, TACT capabilities, balancing for flow, interval within the pacemaker, you know, so hijunkus, how are we going to do that, logic charts, all that good stuff is at a pacemaker, and there's actually design guidelines to do that. Beyond that, there's shared resources. Every factory has shared resources. Well, there's other 6 tenants that say, here's how you should handle shared resources. The message here, it's not left up to management, it's not left up to brainstorming. And it's the same in the supply chain. We shouldn't be having managers to figure out how we should apply our supply chain. There's actually guidelines on how to do it if you want a nice, robust flow that yields operational excellence in your supply chain. Finally, the office. About things like workflow cycles, integration events, processing cells, all that stuff happens in the office to create a flow, and there's guidelines to do that. So the key here word, a key message here is that value streams are not done by brainstorming. Future state value streams are not done by brainstorming, they're done by designing. If you design them to run a certain way, well, then you'll have that checklist just like the pilot does up in his plane.